Hi guys, my name is David from Pay It Forward.
And I'm David from Pay It Forward.
And in this video, we're going to answer the question, can an iPhone get a virus? So I'll pose that question to you. Can an iPhone get a virus?
Well, the answer is yes. And I originally wrote an article a while back where I said no, and then I get a lot of angry comments from people. And so I did some more research into it. It turns out that yes, it's very rare, but iPhones can get viruses.
And what we're going to do is we'll talk about a few of the ways that can happen and show you how to avoid those potential pitfalls.
Mm-hmm.
So number one is don't jailbreak your iPhone.
Right. So a lot of people are going to jailbreak their iPhone. And if you've never heard of jailbreaking before, what a jailbreak is removes Apple's restrictions on what apps can and cannot do that protect your file system on your iPhone from getting viruses. So, for instance, when you open an app on your iPhone, it opens in what's called a sandbox, and that app has very specific access to other apps or to the files on your iPhone. It can only do these little things. When you jailbreak your iPhone, you're taking it out of jail, and now this one app can do anything on your iPhone, including give it malware and install apps that aren't approved by Apple.
So don't jailbreak your iPhone.
Right. The other piece of it is that Cydia is the sort of app store for jailbreaking.
Yep.
Instead of the app store, they have Cydia. So Cydia is full of apps that just do all sorts of stuff with your iPhone.
Right.
There's some pluses, some negatives. We just say don't do it.
So that's jailbreaking. Number two is update your iPhone regularly.
Mm-hmm.
And we're actually going to show you how to do that with the screen recording here.
Yeah, sure.
But let's talk about why it's important to do that.
Sure. Well, periodically, Apple releases software updates that address bugs and fixes. They don't always make everything public that they find, but software updates fix problems.
Yep. So update your iPhone. Just open the settings app.
Yeah.
You're going to get it here. You're going to tap general.
Yeah.
Software update.
Mm-hmm.
And then it'll say checking for update. If an update is available, you'll be able to see download and install. You can tap that. My iPhone is up to date.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a good idea to keep your iPhone software up to date. Absolutely.
Yep. The next one is when you're using Safari or another web browser,
mm-hmm.
just avoid unfamiliar websites because occasionally you get a bad pop-up, which can be not great for your iPhone.
Here's the way that people get viruses on iPhones and on Apple computers. Usually it's not that they just get a virus from nowhere. What happens is they go to a website and it's like, hey, Adobe Flash needs to be updated, to keep you safe. Download now. It's like,
two virus have been detected on your Apple iPhone.
Two virus. Well, with the grammar, we should have been tipped off right away.
Right.
But a lot of people see these things, and these types of pop-ups are meant to scare you. So people go ahead and just download the software. And by downloading the software that's supposed to keep you safe, you're actually installing a virus on your iPhone. So especially if you go to a website and you say, virus detected on iPhone. Like that, you don't have a virus.
Right.
Don't install. But if you download that, then you will have a virus.
Right. So what do you do when this happens? Well, first of all, close out of Safari and close the app.
Right.
So we're going to close out of it.
Mm-hmm.
Double click the home button to open the app switcher and to swipe that right up and off the screen.
Mm-hmm.
And then you want to clear Safari history and website data.
Right. And this is the most important part. We're going to go to settings.
So we're going to go to settings. I just did my software update. My iPhone looks great.
Yep.
We're going to scroll down here to Safari. We're going to tap that. Scroll down again, clear history and website data, just tap that.
Right.
Do I want to do it? Yes, I do. It'll clear history, cookies, and other browsing data.
Mm-hmm.
Tap that.
Yeah, and also close out all your tabs in Safari.
So fourth up is don't plug your iPhone into devices you do not trust.
Mm-hmm.
And we actually read an article on CNN recently which talked about this.
Right. So CNN interviewed someone from the security firm Authentic 8, and this is what he said. Just by plugging your iPhone into a compromised power strip or charger, your device is now infected, and that compromises all of your data. But the point is that public chargers, whenever you're plugging your iPhone into a charger, let's say in the airport or anywhere else, you're giving that charger access to not just the power on your iPhone, but the files on your iPhone. Just every time you plug your iPhone into iTunes, the data can be transferred back and forth. So hackers have found ways to infect iPhones with just public chargers that seem completely innocent, but not innocent.
So those are the four steps. Now, if you want to take it one step further, there are some apps in the App Store which can help you keep your iPhone secure, like Norton and McAfee.
Yep.
But we don't really think those are necessary. It's kind of overkill at that point.
Yeah, a lot of people are scared, so I think that companies... Here, I'm going to diss them. Can I diss them?
You can diss them.
All right. I think a lot of people get scared and from viruses, especially if they're experienced with PCs that get viruses, all the time. But what happens is they get scared. And so McAfee and Norton, other people have figured out that they can capitalize, sort of on the fear and put iPhone apps in the App Store that do other things, to be fair, but are really unnecessary on iPhones. And for that matter, on Macs too.
So there you go. There you have it. Can an iPhone get a virus? Yes, they can.
Because My opinion on this thing, just to cut to that, is that if somebody is that smart, like if you're being hacked by a government or something, they're probably going to find a way to get the stuff on your iPhone.
Yep.
Or they'll just send someone to steal your iPhone, you know, but Apple is wonderful at keeping just sort of the small-time hackers at bay. So, you know, usually the answer is no, but we wanted to tell you the truth.
So we actually really look forward to hearing back from you in the comments section about your thoughts on this topic.
Please feel free to say, you know, whatever you think. Be honest, you know, because they were really mean to me on the website.
And maybe if we get enough comments, we can do a nice little negative comments video answering these people directly.
Yes.
So thumbs up this video if you enjoyed, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for the best iPhone content on YouTube.